choosing the furnace, God is not double-minded, neither should we be. A shout out to those of you who have chosen the furnace over bowing down to the pressure of media, family, friends, neighbors, co-workers, bosses, and politicians. Let us remember the story of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in Daniel 3:16. We are in the last days of the end time, and God is dividing those who will follow him at any cost from those who already melt in the heat outside the furnace. Inside the furnace are those who have chosen to stand firm on God's word, those who are being purified to become gold, the remnant who are being prepared to work in the great soul harvest that is coming soon. So keep on standing. You are not alone. Aside from other believers, Jesus is with you in the furnace. Here's a word of caution. First of all, let me say that I sense like never before that one of the central issues on God's heart seems to be the issue of abortion or child sacrifice. Many Christian leaders agree to this. The fact is that anyone who truly believes in the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob could never ignore or support those who stand for sacrificing babies, as this is demonic Baal or Molech worship. If you claim to be a Christ follower and in any way support child sacrifices, I must warn you that you are not saved and going to heaven. God is not double-minded, and neither are his true followers. Those who argue that they do not get involved in politics and do not vote must understand that, whether they like it or not, by paying taxes, they automatically participate in their country's business. With people's tax dollars, abortion clinics are funded. That is why believers must be engaged and vote. The church was never meant to be a private club. We are here to make a positive difference by showing the light of Christ and pushing for God's standards to be implemented wherever we are. Leviticus 20, verses 2 to 5. Any Israelite or any foreigner residing in Israel who sacrifices any of his children to Molech is to be put to death. The members of the community are to stone him. I myself will set my face against him and will cut him off from his people. For by sacrificing his children to Molech, he has defiled my sanctuary and profaned my holy name. If the members of the community close their eyes when that man sacrifices one of his children to Molech, and if they fail to put him to death, I myself will set my face against him and his family, and will cut them off from their people together with all who follow him in prostituting themselves to Molech. Important to note here, the Lord doesn't change his mind. Numbers 23, verse 19. God is not man that he should lie, or a son of man that he should change his mind. James 4, verse 8. Draw near to God, and he will draw near to you. Cleanse your heart, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. There's also James 1, verse 8. The good news is that God is merciful to forgive anyone who repents and humbly asks his forgiveness. No sin, yes, even abortion, is too great for our God to forgive. He even forgave King David, who killed a man, and he forgave the criminal who was hanging next to Jesus on the cross. There's only one condition. You must really mean it. God sees into our heart and knows. He knows us. 1 Samuel 16:7 reads the following. The Lord does not look at the things people look at. People look at the outward appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart. Isaiah 43, verse 25. I, even I, am he who blots out your transgressions for my own sake, and I will not remember your sins. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. 2 Corinthians 5:17. If you truly believe that Jesus is who he says he is, you must choose whom you will serve. This life here on earth is nothing compared to eternal life in heaven. A decision must be made before it is too late. 1 Thessalonians 5:2. The day of the Lord's return will come unexpectedly, like a thief in the night.